Hey everybody, my name is Daniel from Extreme Food Reviews, and today I wanted to talk to you about Morningfame. Morningfame is a fantastic program that helps creators who have small channels just like mine find relevancy on YouTube in areas and niches that may seem tough to break into. Morningfame can help you stick your foot in the door and find rank for search and suggested in places that you didn't think that you could. What I like to do is show you how I use Morningfame before I ever even start filming. Let's go over to the computer. So first, we want to log into our Morningfame account. Morningfame has a ton of amazing options, but for today, we're just going to focus on the keyword research tool. Up in the right-hand corner, click on the three horizontal bars and then hit the keyword research tool. We're going to click on tab number three, the search tab. And because we're eating a tarantula in our upcoming video, let's enter something into the search that seems reasonable as a potential title for this tarantula adventure. Oh wow, that was actually a decent stab. The first thing we look for is a green check mark next to the ranking opportunity rating, and there it is. That tells us that people actually search for this term. It's got a pretty high score of 80, so we're already on the right path. Let's look at the grading. Now, a quick way of understanding the grading system is that Morningfame looks at the overall topic and gives us grades based on the statistics of other small channels against our own channel, so that we can see how we might stack up in terms of potential for ranking. The idea is if they were able to do it, maybe we can. So right off the bat, we get an A for relevance in this potential title. We know that YouTube rewards relevancy, so this is a fantastic start. The rule of thumb here is that we would at least like to get an E grade on all of these other metrics. So I see an E grade for subscriber count, or how our subscriber count stacks up against both the competition and gateway videos. We also get a D in views, which is awesome. We actually aren't doing that bad in this category. Likes and comments, not so good. We got an F. That one hurts. But we actually aren't that far off from the gateway video when we look closely. They have a score of 76 and we have 50. I know our likes and comments have really been growing lately, so we may actually have a shot at this one. Back up at the top, that green check mark tells us that people actually search this term. So let's scroll down and find out more by using the Google Trends quick link button that Morningfame provides for us right here. This feature is really amazing because it instantly opens up a Google Trends window with our targeted title preloaded into the search term window. The default Google Trends setting will show us our search term worldwide over the past 12 months in all categories in YouTube search. And there we go. Pretty decent historical data that this search term isn't just trending recently. It's got some legs. 8 of them. Like a spider. But we want to know if this title has been searched beyond just YouTube. Let's check the historical web search history for the same time period. And boom, another win. This is incredibly important because being able to potentially rank in Google search results as a YouTube video as well as YouTube search results can have a huge impact on potential views. While we're here, let's check an alternative search term and see how it ranks. We're eating a zebra tarantula, so let's put that in as a search term. Maybe that'll keep my mind off of the fact that I just said we'll be eating a zebra tarantula. The great thing about Google Trends is it allows you to put in multiple search terms and compare their search history as separate colored graphs. Well, that's interesting. In web search, zebra tarantula is actually outperforming eating a tarantula as a search term. Keep in mind, that could include people just looking to learn about this spider, not necessarily looking to make it their dinner. So let's click back and see how it performs in YouTube search. Well, there you go. See, we just learned that in YouTube, it isn't as highly searched as our first target, but it definitely has some longer-term search history. So let's not forget that fact. Let's keep that in mind. Back in the Morningfame keyword research tool, let's quickly check what the search term zebra tarantula might do for us. All right. It's got a green check that we like. That means that it has got some historical search, which we knew from Google Trends. But it's a lower search volume than our other target compared to an 80. Again, Google Trends confirmed this when we looked at the graphs. But then again, I've got better grades on the other variables with 1D and 2Es. No F. Not a lot better, but I'll keep that in mind. When I look at these two, I'm not convinced that this is the better option. I'm going to throw all my chips in on the search term, eating a tarantula, even though I know I had one F for likes and comments. I may still have a good shot at ranking for it, and it has much better potential if I do. We have the option of learning a whole lot more about other videos and how they rank for this search term, but I've got a tarantula waiting. Let's move on. So let's use this search term for the next step, step number four. When we click here, Morningfame instantly gives us a layout for optimizing our upload, just like YouTube would in the editing phase. There's a spot for title, there's a spot for description, and there's a spot for tags that give us a score and tips in order to get all of these things optimized and working towards helping us rank. The title is automatically inserted, so for now, let's move on to the description. We want to get our title into the very beginning of our description as to reinforce that metadata. So let's think of how we can use the term eating a tarantula in a descriptive sentence. Did you see our relevance score go up on the left? That means we're doing the right thing. Let's fill out the description a little more for the time being. We can tweak this later, but for now we want to get a full 20% out of 20% in the description optimization achievement bar. It turns green when we've hit our target. Everything just helps broaden that description from there on in, which is always a good thing. So think of interesting things that might help expand our description and engage the viewer. Next, let's move down to the keyword tags. We're going to see that some were automatically generated. Some of these are narrowly focused and some are more broad. Morningfame gives us a wide spectrum to work from, but today we have a tough challenge, so I'm going to stay fairly narrow in my focus. Each keyword that has a search history comes with a green check next to it. That tells us that these terms are not only good tags, but people actually use them as search terms. Let's narrow that focus by eliminating any tag that isn't historically searched. Morningfame has a button for that too. Now let's consider some tags that might help YouTube understand what this video is about. Clicking the tags tip tells us that we should try finding long tail search terms that start with our whole target term and use those tags to help describe our video. So we have eating a tarantula. We can click on suggested and see if Morningfame can give us some more ideas as well. Let's try eating a tarantula challenge. This is where using your imagination is really helpful too. How about eating a tarantula whole? Or eating a tarantula in a can. It did come in a can. We know that this is a zebra tarantula, and we know that search term has some crossover value as well. So let's throw a few of those related tags in there. As you can see, we've hit our optimized 40% out of 40% tag target goal. So let's go back to our title. As tough as a target as this one is, it wouldn't hurt if we added something to the end of our title to potentially extend our short title a bit and open up some other potential relevancy. If we don't hit our current target of eating a tarantula, at least we'll be well positioned to pivot to the somewhat easier target of zebra tarantula if we have to re-optimize later. So we add that into the title, which will drop our optimization score very slightly. But if you click on the blue tip button next to our title, it tells us that adding a few words at the end of our title to intrigue people to click is actually a good idea. It even has a great link about how to craft the perfect title with the help of our old pal, Brian G. Johnson. So now we double check everything to see that we've hit all of our targets for optimized title, description, and tags, all before we've ever started filming. Let's click and save, and all of this will be waiting for us when we come back. The best part is when we do come back and our video is completed and ready for uploading, each area has an individual copy to clipboard button that copies all of the information within that block so we can quickly copy and paste it right into YouTube title, descriptions, and tags. How easy was that? No more writing titles, descriptions, and tags just hoping that they'll help you rank. Morningfame gives you the ability to really focus on strategic keyword research that can give your channel the best chances of ranking for the very search terms you need to. So there you have it. That's exactly what I do before I even start filming. I want to know my title, I want to know my description, and I want to know that my tags, all three, are optimized to give me the best chance of ranking for the search terms that I'm targeting. Morningfame takes something that seems really difficult and makes it so simple to do. The reason knowing this information is important before is because you don't want to go into YouTube blindly shooting at targets, having no idea whether you can achieve achieve ranking for them at all. You want to have focus in what you do. You want to have focus in your titles, focus in your description, and focus in your metadata. And that metadata includes things like your raw video file that you upload or your thumbnail. A raw video file may have 9762348.mp4. I know that I'm going to be eating a tarantula, so if I'm going to upload a thumbnail, I want the thumbnail to be named Eating a Tarantula. And I want the raw video file to be named Eating a Tarantula. That way, when all of my titles, descriptions, tags, video file, and thumbnail are presented with their metadata fully optimized, they're all telling YouTube the same thing. This is what this is about. This is where this belongs on YouTube, and that will help you rank in your niche. I really hope this was helpful, and I hope you use Morningfame to help you rank the way I've gotten my channel to rank. Best of luck, and I'll keep an eye out for you. Peace out.